Yo, and welcome back, gangsters. In this video, we're going to show you how to coach high performers, the 7 tips that you must absolutely know. And if you want to learn how to coach high performers, and a lot of them get clients as them, then make sure you stick around to the end of this video. I'll show you the blueprint that you need in order to acquire high performing clients. And if you want to make gains in your coaching business week after week after week, then make sure you hit the subscribe button so you get notified when I post videos every single Thursday. I'm actually here today with one of the world's leading men's coaches, Michael Rostosky, who's a good friend of mine. And we're gonna be talking together about how to coach high performers, because you were one of the first people to powerfully coach me in my life.
That is true, and now we're friends.
And now we're buddies. Hey, okay. And without any further ado, number one is clear your judgment. I feel like so many coaches get into an environment with a high performer, maybe because the coach doesn't feel like a high performer themselves, and so they automatically, unconsciously, will judge the high performer in front of them.
Yeah, and you can't help someone that you judge, so you can't love someone that you judge. So if you have any kind of judgments of the person that you're coaching, you actually can't help them at all. So go to your coach or go to your mentor or do some sort of work, some thought work, like the work of Byron Katie is super good, because if that judgment is there, then you'll unconsciously like not even be able to help them.
So love them completely and release yourself from judgment. Number two is celebrate their wins. If there's one thing that I've noticed about coaching high performers, whether it's Jake Paul or Logan Paul or any other of the social media influencers or any of the hundreds of coaches that I've worked with, almost invariably, they get used to accomplishing but not used to celebrating. So whenever I start off a coaching session, first thing is, tell me your wins from the last week, something you can be excited about.
What's funny is that I didn't know that before. I do the same thing with all of my clients too. So it's like the same exact thing, because you get to go into the call with the energy of celebration. And again, a lot of high performers are just, they're out there kicking ass, working, performing. So that celebration actually increases the energy for the call, and then you're able to go into like the deeper parts of their life.
And nothing works for productivity like happiness.
That's true.
So get them happy before you get them going. Number three is teach responsibility. This is the number one most important thing in my mind that causes people to evolve, is when they see that everything in their life is actually of their own creation. Their feelings, their experiences in relationships, their body, their business, their whatever, they are responsible. So if there's any one gift that you can give to a high performer, it's to show them how they've created their life. And guess what else? They can create a different one too.
That's pretty much it. Coaching is literally helping people and being a mirror for them for everything that comes out of their mouth. The words reflect back their internal experience, and anything that has any kind of victimhood or anything like that just isn't true. So by supporting them in the process of them really learning to take just full responsibility for every minute aspect of their life, their business, their family's lives, just everything, even the world, you can go to say, then they will just inevitably be happier and more fulfilled, and everything will grow.
Number four is tell the truth. Unfortunately, high performers live in a bubble. Most people are afraid to share what they feel is true with the person in front of them, whether positive or negative. The coach's job is to honestly be the person that encourages their gifts, but also calls them out on their BS when it's apparent to them.
And for me, I actually feel comfortable. I'll even sometimes share some of my vulnerabilities and some of my stories, because then they can see, you know, their life through my life. And for me, being vulnerable with my clients opens up so much space for them to share even more. So one truth right now is I don't do a lot of YouTube videos, so I feel a little uncomfortable right now, but I'm doing it because I know that the more that I practice anything, the better I get at it.
Drop a truth bomb. Bah, 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 bah. Number five is be comfortable with silence. It's uncomfortable, right? That is where breakthroughs often happen, is right in the silence, because then a person that you're talking with or that you're coaching has to really face what they're feeling. And when they can face and take responsibility for what their actual experience is, they can become free of it.
Yeah, the less you talk, and I know this might even sound counterintuitive because you're someone that provides great value and you've probably done a lot of programs and you have a lot of wisdom, but trust me, the less you talk, the more they'll really, really be able to go into the deepest breakthroughs. Mm-hmm. So your number one job as a coach is to ask them the questions that everyone else in their life is afraid to ask them. And by doing that, one question can literally change their entire life, entire business, entire relationship. And that starts with being comfortable with silence.
Number six is challenge them. With a high performer, they are used to people around them either giving them crap for their success, like calling them down to a lower level, or esteeming them into greatness, flattery, which doesn't feel good either. So what the high performer most needs is for someone to stand by and judging them based on their level of capability towards what's possible. What high performers love is growth. And so what the coach's job is to call them forth into that growth, because that in the long term is what will make the high performer not only productive, but happy.
Yeah, and if you're scared to challenge them, then you're doing them a huge disservice. So get your ego out of the way and recognize that, like, you're not only there to love them and support them, but you're also them to say, hey, like, you can do better. So really, really hold them to the highest standard, and you'll never ever have to worry about like getting clients or doing that, because the power of your coaching will, like, they'll never forget what you did for them in their life. And that comes from challenging their bullshit and their beliefs.
Number seven, but before I share with you number seven, comment below right now, below this video, and let me know, what kind of clients do you coach currently or you would like to coach? Do you coach people in fitness, in business, in life, whatever it is? Comment below to let me know. Now, number seven is give action items. Nothing that you talk about on the call will be relevant or helpful unless the person decides to do something different as a result of your call. That's why at the end of my coaching sessions with high performers, I say, I give you three things that you're going to do between now and our next session. And if you don't do them, there's going to be hell to pay. Hold them accountable for what they've learned or decided during that session.
And if they don't do it, then ask them why. So again, hold them accountable and have some sort of system. It can be software, it can be anything, it can be a notebook that holds them accountable to that, which will create structure that will inevitably support them in getting success in every area of their life.
Now, one more thing before you go. If you do want to coach high performers and you want to attract more of them into your business, into your life, then make sure you click the link right below this video to where you can download my 6 Steps to 6 Figures blueprint. And in it, you'll learn the 6 steps that you need to grow a 6-figure coaching business. And the fastest way to do that is to charge higher prices, working with high performers. So click the link below this video and download it. Make sure to like this video on your way out and subscribe and hit the little bell next to the button after you subscribe so you get notified when I post these videos week after week, and share it with your friends. If you enjoyed it, share the love, bring it to more people. One more thing, I wanna thank Michael Rostosky for being here, one of the world's best coaches for men. Everyone, thank him in the comments as well for bringing so much value. I appreciate you, brother.
Thank you, brother.
Woo! And we'll see you tomorrow. Peace. Wait, come on. Peace, love, and gains, baby. Woo! Number one is... Oh, wait, I'm gonna say it.
You're amazing. You're YouTube.
Thank you, bro.
You're just a YouTube creation, like, machine. It's awesome.
Number six is challenge them.
Start over.
Ha ha ha.